ஸ்ரீ குருவியோ நமக சில்ட்ரன். இன் ப்ரீவியஸ் டாபிக் யூ ஹாவ் லேர்ன் ஃபுட் ஃப்ரம் பிளான்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபுட் ஃப்ரம் அனிமல்ஸ். டுடே வி வில் லேர்ன் அபவுட் ஃபுட் ஹேபிட்ஸ் ஆஃப் அனிமல்ஸ். வி சீ சோ மெனி அனிமல்ஸ் அரவுண்ட் அஸ், ரைட்? ஹாவ் யூ அப்சர்வ் எனி அனிமல்ஸ் ஈட்டிங் ஃபுட்? வாட் டூ தே ஈட்? Animals eat a variety of food such as plants, seeds, nuts, insects, and flesh of other animals. Based on their eating habits, animals can be classified broadly into three categories: herbivores, carnivores, omnivores. By the end of this chapter, you should be able to state what are herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, scavengers, and decomposers. Now, let's discuss about herbivores. Herba means plant. Ora means to eat. So, herbivores means plant eating animal. Animals that eat only plants or plant parts are called herbivores. These are the examples of herbivores. Now, let's discuss about special features of some herbivores. They have premolars and molars which break down the plant material into fine particles. They also have sharp incisors to bite off plants. In cows, buffaloes, goats, and sheep, a thick gum pad replaces the incisor in the upper jaw. They wrap their tongues around the grass and use their gum pads along with the teeth in the lower jaw to bite the grass. Cattle chew their food twice in order to break it down completely. They chew their food partly and swallow it. This partly digested food, called gut, is brought back into the mouth from the stomach to be chewed again. This act softens and helps break down the plant fibers. Now we see about carnivores. Carne means meat. Ora means to eat. So, carnivores means flesh eating animals. Animals that eat only the flesh of other animals are called carnivores. These are the examples of carnivores. The carnivores have sharp premolars and molars called carnassial teeth with jagged edges. What is the meaning of jagged? Animals that have sharp and uneven edges. Let's see the special features of some carnivores. They have sharp and pointed canines to tear off large pieces of flesh. Animals also have four kinds of teeth, like incisor, canine, premolar, and molars. Jaguars also one of the example of carnivores. Jaguars are quick runners. This helps them to catch their prey easily. They have big and strong claws to hold their prey. Next, see children, have you noticed the eagles flying in the sky and catch their prey on the ground in a matter of few seconds? Eagles and owls have sharp eyesight to spot the prey. Chameleons and frogs have long and sticky tongues to catch insects. Let's see the next topic, omnivores. Animals that eat plant as well as flesh of other animals are called omnivores. The term omnivore is derived from the Latin word omni means all and ora means to eat. So omnivores means to eat plants as well as flesh of other animals. These are the examples of omnivores. Let's see the special features of some omnivores. Human being is an example of omnivores. Human beings have blade-like incisors to bite, sharp canines to tear, and flatter and broader molars and premolars to chew the food. Squirrels have sharp-edged front teeth called incisors to facilitate gnawing. Let's see the next topic of scavengers. Organisms that feed mainly on dead and decaying animal and plant matter are called scavengers. Scavengers keep the ecosystem free of dead animals. These are the examples of scavengers. Next, decomposers. What is decomposers? Organisms that obtain nutrients by breaking the remains of dead organic matter are called decomposers. These are the examples of decomposers. Most of the microorganisms are decomposers. Fungi also one of the decomposers. Organisms that are too small to be seen with the naked eye are called microorganisms. We can see through the microscope. Decomposers break down the dead or decaying organic matter into the nutrients such as nitrogens and carbon, which in turn can be used by the living plants and animals. I hope you have understood the topics that we discussed today. Thank you, children.